Rogers, Ottawa, or Rogers Community 22. Glenn, why are you crying?
I'm messing with you, you haven't reached your climax. The time is all the dark cause I read you like a Timex. Excuse me for my rudeness, but that's how I am. And that's how it is. So mind your freaking biz. Coming from below civil with my man Kelly. Doing time for burning Hollywood and now we're feeling good. About the herb, so let me give a word on why it's not absurd.
Wow, holy cow. Holy cow. It's the Zoomalactics. Wow. The Zoomalactics there. That's who that was.
That's pretty good.
That was... yeah, that's who that was. It was the Zoomalactics.
Oh, that's pretty neat.
Wow, that was neat. It's the, we have a special show today.
What?
It's a special show. It's not a normal show today.
Okay.
I guess we can let the cat out of the bag right away.
Go for
it. And tell the people that it's a special show. It's the Will Trenholm special today. It's the Will Trenholm special today.
Who's Will?
Will Trenholm. We're going to be... well,
here we go again.
Phil, no. Phil Giroux and myself, Phil J. Roux, the F-I-L-L J. Roux.
Right.
We were walking through the Rideau Center,
okay.
Last week, and we ran into Will Trenholm.
Okay.
And...
who is he?
We'll see today.
Oh,
we went on and shot some segments with Will.
Oh, good.
Yeah. As well, Rosaline Dixon is here. Rick.
Rosaline Dixon.
She wrote a book about the Free Net.
Yes,
that's it. And Rick Fortier is here. He's a driving instructor. Is here today. Young drivers of Canada here as well. So. And an actor, and an actor named Scott Crow.
Right.
And an actor. And Scott Crow. Again. Some. Yeah.
Insane excitement going on.
It is insane excitement. Well, should we start the Will Trenholm special?
Let's go for it.
Okay, let's introduce everyone to Will Trenholm, and then we'll be right back after this. Okay. The heart of the city today, and I've run into a very special friend of the show, Will Trenholm. Will, thank you for stopping and talking to us today.
No problem.
I ran into Will the other day at the Rideau Shopping Mall, and you were doing funny things at the time.
Yes, I am known to do funny things. Well, if you didn't, like, put that thing into my face.
See? How do you think of all of these crazy things, these funny things you do?
Well, that was real. Didn't you see the guy?
I don't know what you're talking about, Will.
I think I have to.
He's gonna do it again. Look, what are you doing now?
I try to be creative and like do the same thing over and over again.
Do you sometimes feel that you may be repeating yourselves in your style of comedy?
From time to time, like maybe like if I do a certain skit now, you may see me doing this a month from now, like it's really hard, like I can't explain it.
He's doing those things. Okay, well, let's go do some more funny stuff.
All right.
With Will.
Frig Nick! Tie up the shoe!
Yeah.
People are you crying, who's to blame? It is a painful thought through my brain. The strain, the stress, no credit nonetheless. Confess, caress that body with the best. Manna, manna, yeah.
What do you think of the Zoomalactics?
I think they're terrific. How do you spell it?
The Zoomalactics. How do you spell Zoomalactics, guys?
I guess it starts with a Z or something.
Z-O-O-M-A-L-A-C-T-I-C-S.
Talented.
Wow. Look at that, huh? Spelling bee.
Yeah, well, you know. This is Rosaline Dixon, everyone. You've wrote a book.
Yeah, I wrote a book.
You've written a book.
I have written a book. Well, free net. A friend of mine, Pierre Burke, and I wrote it together.
Oh, yeah. Free net for the fun of
free
it.
Free net for the fun of
can
it.
Can I see it?
Sure.
What? Tell me a bit about
it's
it.
It's got
is
something
it?
About Glenn in it.
Has something about Glenn?
Well, yes. You look on page 94, and it tells everything you ever want to know about Glenn. And you did a radio show last
in a
night,
book?
Yeah.
In a book here?
Yeah.
Glenn Humplick.
Glenn Humplick, right. You see, it's got everything in it.
Well known to late night cable TV channel surfers, the personable straight man.
Are you personable?
Something like that.
Are you? Yeah. Okay.
He's been cruising the underbelly of the net since late 1993. Wow! Look at that. Well, that's neat.
Oh.
Notwithstanding his propensity towards practical joke making, Glenn enjoys technology in many ways. Wow.
We have you in it, I'm not sure.
No.
No, but it does mention that he's the straight man on the Tom Green show.
Oh, well, yeah. I thought he was, so. He does a lot of straight man work, actually.
Yeah. Well,
several shows.
Well, I know
he hires himself out on contract.
I heard him on radio last night.
Oh, really?
And that was, yeah, wasn't that a new show? That was really good on the U.
Oh, yeah, Glenn's doing all sorts of stuff. Let's not talk about Glenn, though. Let's talk about the book.
Okay.
Let's talk about the book.
Oh, sure.
We can talk about Glenn later.
Yeah, well, it isn't all about Glenn. That's just one little tiny paragraph. Mm-hmm. But it's all about a lot of different people who are on Freenet and what you can do, you know, what fun you can have.
How'd you get started in Freenet?
I think I read about it in the...
Are you a typical Freenet user?
I don't know if there isn't any such thing, because everybody uses, you know, when you're 50,000 people, there's nobody typical.
Mm-hmm.
People just turn it on. Everything is there. Every kind of person you could possibly imagine.
Wow. Really. Okay, and what else? You're also part of the board of directors for the...
Freenet. That's right. They had an election.
You smiled when I said that.
Yes. Yes. Because there are a lot of people who sort of get really mad at Freenet because they can't stay on. They want to be on Freenet all day long, mm-hmm. and they can't be. So they get mad at the board, and they always say
because of this
weird,
new.
Think we're a bunch of terrible people.
There's a new rule. It's the new two-hour rule.
Yeah, or? That's right. Well, you know, 2 hours sitting in front of the screen, isn't that about enough? But
seems like a lot
some
to
people,
me.
Some people get really worked up about it.
Yeah.
And they hate the board, so I guess we're one of those. Are you one of those people?
No.
Yeah, you're giggling away.
I think Glenn is one of those people.
No, but I mean, if you're, I guess anyone who's ever on the board of anything gets sort of criticized, but they should be happy because they have an awful lot of people using the product, which is free.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of nice.
I have noticed there's been a lot of sort of negative press towards that.
Oh
lately.
Yeah, well, don't you think maybe the paper press, to a large extent, is worried. They're afraid, perhaps, that they're going to disappear.
Oh, yeah.
Because of the internet, so they're afraid of the internet, yeah. And they're afraid that. So they keep accentuating the negative.
Uh-huh.
And they do that because they can't.
Talking about censorship and stuff like that.
Yeah, which is impossible. You can't censor anything on.
You don't like the idea of censorship.
Well, then? I don't even think about it because it's impossible. Because you can't censor something, you can't do anything before it's there. Mm-hmm. And once it's on the screen. Or on the air, or in the, you know, you could be sitting in Sweden or in Australia or somewhere there and write something, and immediately it's all over the world.
I am sitting in Sweden.
Yeah, right there. Okay, right well, now. See what I mean. Yeah. But I mean, you're virtually here.
Yeah, but you don't think there's a way that they could go on and edit these things? You don't agree with
how
that?
How could
I
you
guess.
Edit it?
I mean, well, I mean, some.
You can edit something on paper because
Big Brother.
You can see it before it's printed. Mm. How could you possibly? I mean, how would you?
I don't know. I don't know. I don't know anything about this.
Well, I don't think it can be done.
No, well, that's good.
Yeah,
then,
I'm so clever and I'm so technical. I would understand those.
Well, we have nothing to worry about then.
Not about censorship, I don't think. Maybe unless they want to shut the whole thing down and there'd be people would be so mad that they'd set another one up. There'd be an underground internet.
Oh, we can. Well, this is exciting. Freenet for the fun of it. by Rosaline Dixon and Pierre Bourque. Where can people get this?
Oh, it's in 40 bookstores in Ottawa.
Okay.
And a few of the computer stores. Mm. It's sort of everywhere. It's a kind of a fun book. And also, the main thing is it tells you how to get into Freenet, because, you know, you don't even have to have a computer. Mm-hmm. You just can go to the public library and tune in and register
and
become a member.
So this is the user's manual for the Freenet.
Well, no, it's not a manual. It just tells you how to get in. It doesn't have all the wonderful and exotic things you can do if you're technical, because it's not for technical people. It's just for, like, ordinary guys.
Ordinary people like Glenn and myself.
Ordinary, straight.
Okay, well, thanks a lot, Rosalie. Thank you very much for coming on the show.
Good.
And we'll be right back after Burning Feet Man.
Oh my tooth is killing me. It's toothache I have. It's just horrible.
Your tooth is killing you. Well, have no fear, young man.
Just a second.
You have a toothache. We'll have no fear. Burning Feet Man is here. Try Ambasol. Try Ambasol.
I'm hunting for moths, but I forgot my lantern. And I don't know how I'm going to catch any when I don't have enough light. There's not enough light to attract moths.
I'm Burning Feet Man. I'll bring you light to attract the moths. So come on, moths. Moms!
I have to build a raft to get off of this island before the hurricane comes. But there's not enough light for my solar calculator so I can figure out the calculations.
It's a solar calculator. Is that a solar calculator?
Yeah, but there's not enough light.
Well, have no fear, young man, because Burning Feet Man is here. Light!
Now do your calculations.
Have no fear, because Burning Foot Man is here. Burning Foot Man is here. Have no fear. Do your calculations, young man. Do your calculations.
That's not right. I've just been washing and waxing my car, but I just can't seem to get that brand new store sort of shine.
You want that showroom shine, don't you, young man? Try Ambasol. Try Ambasol. Try Ambasol.
Oh, what? I got a negative. What does that mean?
You've got to add the ones in the brackets first. Add the ones in the brackets first.
Hot, it's 50 cents. 50 cents, I only have a quarter. I put the quarter in, and now I can't get a paper. My last quarter, I wanted to get a paper. But of course, I didn't read the little sign here. No, didn't read until I put my only last quarter in. What?
Burning Feet Man is here.
Burning Feet Man?
Here, of course.
Thank you.
You've got to add the ones in the brackets first. Okay?
I thought I did. What brackets, anyway? A scientific calculator.
There's no brackets on that calculator?
There's no brackets on the calculator.
Oh, God.
God, I think I have a gas leak.
Have no fear.
What's up?
I'm ringing in your ears, ill neck, these
up in skin.
Koreans, ID, interior, right, great Scott.
Check the
damage in my ears, I die. More like Spock with the volcanic hard rock. I tough with Danny that I got. Tour, bring some ill dung, deep ish, man. You're unqualified to try my triad. Yeah.
Oh my God.
Rick Fortier from Young Drivers of Canada. Rick Fortier. So you're a little nervous, or?
Yeah, just a bit.
You don't have to be nervous at all.
I'm less nervous with my students.
Yeah. You're less nervous with your students?
Yeah.
Is it sometimes nerve-wracking with your students?
It can be.
I would think so with new drivers.
Oh yeah, when they don't know what they're doing and they try to kill you or something,
they try to kill you on occasion.
Oh yeah, just minor occasions now and then, about once a week.
Really?
Oh yeah.
What would be a specific time someone's something? I mean, you've been doing this for 6 years, right?
Yep. I have no nerves left.
No.
No, they're gone.
You ever been in a collision?
No.
No, oh, well, that's good.
Knock on wood.
Do you think that's some? Is that something?
Sorry.
Is that something to do with your skills as a teacher? That's
absolutely
evaded and the accidents.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, my screaming and yelling and stomping on my brake pedal.
Wow, that's
He's been there. He's done that.
Yeah. Have you ever had a close call to an accident?
Oh yes. Yeah. Oh yes. Turning left in front of tractor trailers tends to be the best one.
Mm-hmm.
They forget where the brake pedal is, and I teach standards. So once they're on the gas and letting go of the clutch, we're gone.
Wow.
So yeah.
You must be what happened over there, huh?
They're not allowed to do that in the car, okay?
Now I know why they call them the Zoomalactics. I don't know what that means. So you must be a pretty good driver to instruct, though, are you?
I like to think I am.
Yeah. Yeah.
What
did you have special
you?
Training to? Well, I'm not very. I don't know. I've never been in an accident, but I would think as a driving instructor, you must have to have some special training.
Oh yeah. Yeah. We go on course for a month, and we're trained every year.
Oh yeah.
And go back for more training and more training and more training. And
really?
Oh yeah. Cars change. The technology changes. We've got ABS brakes. Mm-hmm. The savior in a crash, which is actually not, but. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so technology changes. So, you know, driving instructions got to change as well.
Automatic braking system.
No.
No?
No. Although some people could use it.
What's ABS then?
Anti-lock braking system.
Oh, anti-lock braking system.
That's when the brain says stop, but the car doesn't want to.
Anti-lock braking system.
You ever stepped on your brake real hard?
No, I haven't.
Why not?
I don't think I have ABS.
No. Have you locked up
the wheel?
I don't
have a car, though, so that's probably part of it.
On your bike.
Yeah.
You ever grab the brake real hard?
Have I ever grabbed the brake? Yeah. I have a skateboard. Do police ever pull over driving school cars? Because I guess if you go and do some crazy thing, and there's, you know, a young person driving who's never really been behind the wheel before, and they go over the median or something like that, would a police car come over and stop you?
Oh yes.
Oh, they would.
Oh yeah. Oh, if you do anything stupid or silly.
So the sign on the roof isn't sort of complete protection from getting pulled over by police. Then.
No.
You can't cut through the soccer field behind your house on the way to work in the morning.
Why not?
Oh, you can do that.
Well, no. No, they tend to get upset when you do stuff like that. Cut other cars off. I don't know.
Okay, well, Rick, I thank you for coming on.
Thank you very much. I saw him Tuesday night.
You saw him before?
I saw him Tuesday night. Where'd he go?
That guy over there?
Yeah. Uh-oh.
Mac?
That's Converse. Mac, right?
Phil, what's going on with Mac?
I have no idea.
Yeah, a lot.
Phyllis?
I think he's agreeing to something that you're... I'm not sure.
Why are you... You're saying yeah a lot, right, Mac?
Yeah, I am. Yeah. It's a good word. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
With me, Phil, when we ran into Will Trenholm. Right?
Interesting. Yeah.
We went into Will Trenholm and the Rideau Center,
mm-hmm.
and we're going to, as I mentioned, it is the Will Trenholm special today. It's the Will Trenholm special. It's the Will Trenholm special today.
So we're going to go down to the Byward Market again and continue with the Will Trenholm special. Oh, well, that's it right there. Did you see that? That was great. Technology at work. Okay, so we'll be right back. Here's
Will. Stuff with Will today in the Byward Market. Okay, I'm going to give you an object that I see around here. I'm going to ask you to do something funny with that object, okay?
All right, that seems sensible.
Okay, how about that sign over there? See that sign? Something funny with the sign, okay, Will? What do you think of?
Well, come here! Out of a 10, I'd give that one a 6.
Okay, well, how about do something funny with this crowd of people now?
No, these look like a bunch of sellouts.
Oh, really? Oh.
No way, man, we never sell out.
What do you think of that, Will? What's...
The pressure around me, I can't take it!
Oh. Will, it's all right, I was only kidding. Come back, Will. Oh, Will, don't do this to us. Will, get up.
Come on, Will.
Yeah. 1, 2. Trifling down the street, listen to the concrete like a dandelion, which must seek the light.
Yeah. All right, that's the Zoomalactics there.
Wow.
So you got some brown shoes on, Glenn.
I got some brown shoes, my first pair of brown shoes, and I put them on today.
So first, Glenn's first pair of brown shoes. Because Glenn always wears black shoes, right? You have a black shower curtain, too?
I do. Although,
are you going to get a brown shower curtain now, too?
I'm moving out in a month, and I think my girlfriend's 1977 world map thing is going to be going up, so that's gone.
What do you mean?
Well, she has a shower curtain of the world, let's say, like the universe, and mine's gone.
Oh, from 1977. Yeah. It's a really old shower curtain.
Yeah.
Is there mold on it? And
moldy
shower curtain. I can see why you'd want to change over from the other one.
Yeah. But you don't like my black shower curtain.
I don't like your black shower curtain, no.
No. You've made fun of it a lot.
Yeah, I have made fun of it a lot. It seems kind of weird, but I think a moldy 1977 map shower curtain would probably not be much better than a black shower curtain.
She wins.
Yeah. So we're going to do the lead from Derek?
Yeah.
Yeah? Are we going to do that?
Well, I guess so.
Okay. Did you vote today?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah?
Did you?
Who'd you vote for? Did I vote for today? No, I didn't vote today, no.
How come?
I live in Quebec.
Oh.
And it's Ontario elections.
Oh, yeah. Did you, last time?
Oh, Derek.
Letter from Derek Harvey. Okay. No, I didn't vote because I live in Quebec, no.
Did you vote last time, though?
Did I vote last?
Last Quebec elections?
I voted in the last Quebec election, yeah.
Well, who'd you vote for?
I voted for Jacques Parizeau.
But why?
And he won. Well, I like his policies, and...
But he wants to separate from Canada.
Oh, well, I may have voted for the wrong guy, then.
Oh, oh, God.
Okay, so a letter from Derek. Letter from Derek Harvey right now. whose sister is in the audience today?
Right?
Yeah.
Right.
That's her right there. Derek Harvey's sister right there, Amber Harvey. Hey, let's have a hand for Derek's sister right there. See over there? Stick your hand up and wave. Yeah, right over there in the corner. Stand up. Stand up and take a bow. All right.
And it's her birthday, too, I think.
Yeah. And it's her birthday today. Yeah. Okay, letter from Derek. We're really falling behind now, aren't we? Okay. Tom, here's an... Tom, here's an embarrassing moment you might remember. You and I were driving through the country roads of southern Ontario on one of the hottest days of that summer. We were smiling, we were laughing, and we were happy. We were Drew Barrymore and Chris O'Donnell in Mad Love.
We didn't read road signs, and we didn't care where we stopped. We sang all the songs, then we sang them again. Then you stopped your happy singing and pointed to a figure cutting the grass away in the distance and said, "That's a nice ass." Oh. I strained to see what looked like a cute farm girl in white shorts. "It sure is," I shouted over Gino Vannelli on the radio. As we got closer to the figure, I realized that our grass cutter was an 8-year-old boy. It was an innocent mistake we made, from a half mile away, but we stopped singing and didn't say a word. We just sped away, wondering what had happened. Our happy day was over because of this. And it was a nice ass, it says at the bottom. I don't know. I apologize. I apologize on behalf of Derek Harvey for that one. Oh boy. Okay, so what's going on now, Ed? Do we know what's going on now? What's going on right now? We're going to a segment. Okay, we'll be right back after this. We went downtown and we wanted to see how much fun we could have. We wanted to see how much fun we could have with masking tape. So we'll be right back after this. Peeler is the world's best peeler. Come in and give it a try. Want to go in and give the Miracle Peeler a try?
No.
It's the world's best peeler. It's the world's best peeler. Sir?
Doesn't matter if your hand's wet. Doesn't matter if you peel towards or backwards. It's just fabulous. It peel a turnip.
You guys doing a project or something?
Something like that. You doing a project?
No, not me.
On.
Hold out your finger. See? See?
In the springtime, yeah. Yes, it's rewind. If you dare to be different, I see the peak in this infant. I keep it hand in the trip.
Wowee. The Zoomalactics, and this is Scott Crowe here. Scott Crowe, he's an actor. You're an actor.
Yeah.
And a singer.
I'm a singer.
And
actor,
a singer?
Actor, singer.
Actor, singer, dancer?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Well, not really. Like, dancing's way third on the list. So.
Dancing's way third. Do you want to do a little dancing, though? Show some of that third place dancing?
Yeah, we can get some music from the boys, and we can do some.
Do you want to? Yeah.
Yeah. Actually, come on, Glenn. You're the straight man. Let's go.
Oh.
Can I do this?
No, okay. No dancing, no?
No? Okay, no dancing.
Well, we could see some if you want to.
No, I mean, if the Zim will, if the, you know.
You played the plant in the Little Shop of Horrors?
Yeah.
How do you play a plant in the Little Shop of Horrors?
You sit backstage with a mic.
Yeah.
And all I did was just, you know, the voice and the singing and all that stuff, you know.
Oh, wow.
Same thing. It's kind of did the same deal as the, you know, the movie, you know, the big.
Hey, Seymour.
No.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's sort of a funny movie with Martin Short in that one.
No.
Yeah, Martin Short's in there?
No, it's
Rick Moranis.
Rick,
same kind of.
And you were in the movie, or?
I was in the movie. Yeah, the guy that gets punched when Steve.
Oh wow, that must have been exciting.
Yeah,
meeting Rick Moranis and everything must have been a really great time.
Yeah, we had coffee together and stuff.
Hmm.
But, yeah.
And now you're going to travel the world and you're going to perform Up With People.
Yeah.
I don't know what that is really.
With People is it's this. Well, they call it a multicultural learning experience, right? And you travel around the world, and they use it's like the musical theater as their vehicle for doing this. And so I'll be in a musical show, and we go around the world, and basically the cast is like they audition people from all around the world. So the whole cast is made of people from around the world. So
holy cow!
Yeah. So
and you're gonna get to travel all over the world and sing and dance.
All over the world, singing and dancing across the world.
What kind of singing do you do?
I mostly do musical theater,
like Greece.
Greece, I did. I was in Greece. Yeah.
You were in Greece.
I was actually in Greece too.
Oh wow.
And, I took, you know, singing lessons for a while, and my music teacher sort of, she stuffed me.
So
into
you
this
could
thing.
Sing for us now.
I could sing.
Okay.
If you wanted.
I'll sing a little bit then.
Okay.
We want to hear Scott sing.
All right. Yeah. All right. Yeah. Hi.
Maybe.
Okay. Should I stand up or?
Yeah, you can stand up if you want. Yeah, you can, if you want to. Yeah.
Okay. It's my. Sure. It's.
I don't.
Oh, I look.
Okay. Just stand. Yeah.
Okay.
Scott Crowe is gonna sing.
Right. Okay. Okay. I'll just do a song. It's from let's see. What's the music called? Big River, based on the Huckleberry Finn story. Okay. So go.
No.
Okay, it was a comedy too, right?
Okay.
Yeah, okay. I see the same stars through my window that you see through yours, but we're worlds apart, just like the earth. Just like the sun, two worlds together. Is it good?
Yeah, that's great.
All right.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow. Jeez. Wow. That's great. Yeah. I really wasn't expecting that at all.
Oh, okay.
And you won an air band competition.
I did. Yeah.
You won an air band competition. You didn't have to sing in that one.
99. No, that's before I could sing.
So I guess you got a big audience here tonight, huh?
It's a great audience. Let's have a hand for the audience. Holy cow.
Yeah, so I guess you're interviewing a guest now, huh?
Yeah, I am in the middle of talking to Scott Crowe. Yeah,
I guess he's an artist, huh?
He's an actor and a performer, yeah.
That's okay because I paint at home, huh?
Uh-huh.
That's why I boil my water.
What?
So, I guess this guy's a plumber, huh? Because my mom, she broke her leg, huh? That's why I'm
Mike,
boiling my water.
No, he's an actor.
So, I guess he's a veterinarian, huh? Because last week I watched Chicago Hope, huh? It's a good show, huh?
He's an actor, Mike. He's an actor. He's not on Chicago Hope. He's
so
not
I guess
a veterinarian.
I guess
no
this guy here, I guess
There's
he's
no
a magician,
veterinarians
huh?
on Chicago Hope. Scott, I'm sorry. Thanks for coming on the show, Scott. Scott Crowe.
So,
Trevor?
Yeah? Tom?
You using the washroom right now, or?
No, I'm just,
just
reading.
Yeah.
Guys, you're yelling at me.
I know, I'm sorry. Okay, well, let's go. Let's go. I'm sorry, okay? Talk about the excellent adventure segment that you and Darcy did.
Oh,
you guys did a really good job on the weekend.
Thanks.
Come on. Darcy, come on. We're gonna go talk about the excellent adventure segment that you guys did on the weekend. You guys did a really good job.
Darcy and Trevor! So, thanks, guys.
No problem.
We went out on the weekend, mm-hmm. and you guys started a little business kind of thing.
Yeah, we did.
A lemonade stand.
A lemonade stand.
We sure did.
Made big bucks, too.
Yeah.
Big bucks.
This was part of the, to demonstrate the bargaining thing.
Yeah, the bargaining thing. Yeah. Didn't work too well, though. Yeah. Well, actually, it didn't work
yeah,
too bad.
Yeah, because Darcy does a lot of bargaining. Okay, yeah. So well, let's go look at that then.
Yeah.
You want to look at it? It's a part of Darcy, and it's the second installment of Darcy and Trevor's excellent cross-country adventures.
Hey, this is an experiment. They wanted us to go out and just try to sell lemonade anywhere. Like, they gave us the bare minimum, as you can see, and they tried to say, sell it for $3, come back and see how much profit you made.
Wild, wild.
How'd you like a cup?
No.
$3.
No thanks. No thanks. No thanks.
Best price in town for lemonade.
Woo!
We're not doing too good in front of the Terry Fox statue. I think there's too many other vendors around. Seems to be hampering our business. We're gonna...
Is this guy selling t-shirts?
So we're gonna move down the block. Picking up. We're picking up and moving down. Oh, look at that. We're getting something here. Lemonade, $3.
Gentlemen, some change?
I don't have any change.
Well, do you do the pouring then?
Okay. Trev, you left our cookies again, man.
Well, just, I can only hold so many things.
We're going to get ripped off. All our stock is going to be gone.
The cookies now!
Man, make me do everything.
Fill her up with unleaded. Fill it up with unleaded.
Yeah.
Top of that, we get two cookies. It's our special deal.
Oh, what a sucker, eh? That's not lemonade. Would you like some ginger ale?
No, thanks.
No, of course you wouldn't, because that's lemonade. Hey, what do you got in your little container there?
Ginger ale.
Ginger ale.
Pink lemonade! Rehydrate yourself! Pink lemonade, $3! $3!
That's a good tactic, Trev. Yelling, You are my brother. You are my son. That always works in Turkey. I know that. You are my son. You are my son. I'm your father.
Make them and I sell them for $5.
$5, and you're telling us that $3 is expensive.
Well, the materials to make this stuff with is...
Well, that's the best lemonade you can get.
No, thank you.
$3, you can drink lemonade.
No, thank you. I'm not wasting my money on a glass of lemonade.
You're my brother. You're my brother. No?
We're not free at all.
We're not free?
We have no freedom at all here.
Why is that?
I don't like it. I don't like Canada at all.
You don't like Canada? Where are you from?
I'm from Canada. Oh, I know you're stimulated with this dreadhead flow. I separate the numb from skulls, then release frustration. What stays within all those peoples with no patience? I don't think or hesitate to concentrate, to humiliate, to those who think they're great. Stealing my style, the tactics is in a loaded my vocabulary. I'm like when people try to bite,
go. I'll get my 17th year. Zoomalactics. Zoomalactics, and that was the Zoomalactics.
Yeah.
You know who's on the show next week?
Yeah.
Next week, the mayor of Ottawa's on the show next week.
Really?
Jacqueline Holtzman's on the show next week.
Really?
I'm serious. To have Melissa to thank for that.
Wow.
Melissa Durrell's set that up. Yeah. So
I've had...
What?
I've had one of these days.
Oh, did you have something you wanted to say?
No, I'm just... Well, unless, of course, you don't mean to say it.
No, I don't care. I had nothing to say either, so I mean, look, if you want to say... Okay, what?
Woke up this morning, and I don't know if this has ever happened to you, but couldn't find my deodorant.
Okay. Yeah, that happens to me all the time. No, I don't know. Anyways, yeah.
One of those weird things, woke up, couldn't find it. So, ended up wearing Secret instead. And I've been feeling, like, really weird all day about it.
Yeah. Strong enough for a man, but made for a woman. Yeah.
I'm feeling, all day I've been avoiding my coworkers because I was worried they'd smell it off.
Was it strong enough for a man, Glenn?
It seemed okay. Yeah. Wow. Did the trick. It just smelled funny.
Yeah, well, you smell pretty good to me. You smell like roses.
Well, it's weird,
So it's the Will
Trenholm. Why did I say that?
I don't know. It's nice, though. It's fun. No, I'm glad you did. It's the Will Trenholm special. So, all right. All righty. So, we'll be right back after the last and final installment of the comedy of Will Trenholm.
All right.
Well, what gets me going, or what makes me tick, is basically if I look at the sky, I see it's nice and blue. And to me, that's like great weather for a scene. And that's when I start to rev up. Engine is flowing. Oh, sorry. Got it carried away there. Sorry about that.
It's okay. Okay. You have any option now to do anything funny you want here in the market today. And go ahead with that, Will, and we'll just sit back and we'll document it here on videotape for the Tom Green Show. Will, on Will, Funny Things with Will, downtown. All righty, style portion.
This is the big cheese. Okay, I heard you smirking at me. I heard you.
This is a little different.
You have no right whatsoever to smirk at me.
Well, that about wraps it up, I guess, for Funny Things with Will on the Market. We have a tight segment here, and it's really a good thing that we ran into him today. It made our job a lot easier, and we have a nice, fun-filled 3 or 4 minutes for the show this week. Okay, Trap? That's great. Great. Good thing we ran into you, Will. It's going to really help us out a lot.
Creations are created by the methods of the mind. Swine round suit, thing that wax to the crop. Cause I bring the ting-a-ling ting. Once I was an infant, now I'm the presence of a teen. Switch the patterns of a street kid that will work. Check it. Zero tolerance is into today's world. Great. I had 2 options to drop out of school. No shit, middle off a turn for money.
Geez, you know, I was really looking forward to the Will Trenholm special, but I'm not sure anymore. I was really excited about it, you know.
Different.
Wow.
People at home are
hysterics. I don't know. Yeah, I think maybe it went over better at home.
Yeah.
That's what it is, I think. I think probably on your couch. Yeah. Oh, Sean Cookson! Yeah, Sean Cookson!
Thanks, your boys. Thanks, boys.
Have you done work with the Zoomalactics before, Sean? Or?
No, first time at them tonight.
You're meshing. You guys are meshing. That was great.
Oh yeah, we're meshing.
Yeah.
Meshing.
Meshing.
I like that word.
I've never used that word. I don't know what that word is.
So I haven't been here for a while because I've been over in what do you call it? The old country, Europe.
Yeah.
I was over in Europe, right? I'm touring around. Well, I really went over there just to do mechanics.
Okay. Okay. You're from Europe, or?
No.
Okay.
I just went over there with my buddy Antoine.
Oh, it's old, though.
Yeah,
Europe Antoine. Is old.
Yeah, the old country.
Mm-hmm.
This is a new country, old country, you know. Mm-hmm.
It's a continent, actually.
Right. It's an island, big thing.
Mm, okay.
So anyway, so I'm over there. I was really going to do mechanics in France, okay? But I didn't know French, so I didn't do very well. So I decided to tour with my buddy Antoine,
mm-hmm.
who was French but didn't really understand what the thing was with mechanics.
Okay.
So we decided to tour, and the worst thing about Europe is bugs.
Mm-hmm.
I slept in a tent one night there, Tom. I'm telling you, oh, bug flew in my ear.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Little moth about this big just goes all of a sudden in my ear. Mm-hmm. I flick it, think it's gone. Going back up that. Oh, God! Ah, bug in my ear, in my ear, it's flipping around in there.
Wow.
Hey, Antoine, get the goddamn tweezers.
Ooh, boy.
Man, it was flipping around in there, I couldn't get it out.
Yeah.
If you ever want to torture anybody, put a bug in his ear.
The European bugs are the worst, too.
European bugs, they don't leave you alone, they're bugging you all the time, right? So really what I wanted to say, I was down in this...
What do they call a quarter pounder with cheese in Europe? A royale with cheese.
Exactly. Good one. So anyway, so I'm over there. I'm on this little island called Timwakluk.
Oh, wow.
And so it's right beside Ekwak. And so I met up with this guy. His name's Dimwit. And he's like a Buddhist guy, right?
Okay, yeah.
And he teaches the mind bending, right?
Okay.
So you use your mind, you can strengthen your mind to move stuff, bend it, you know, freaky stuff.
And you
like
went all
that,
the way over there to
yeah, to bend stuff.
Okay.
Well, I couldn't learn anything in mechanics because I couldn't speak French.
Okay. Is this a Gatorade commercial? Or?
Oh, I don't know.
Okay.
Sure.
Sure.
You want
okay.
to be?
Okay, and
so
what happened?
So now, I told you. So now I'm going to show you.
Okay.
So this
you're
going to
bend the spoon with your mind.
I'm going to bend this spoon.
That's what we're talking about.
With
here.
My mind.
You're going to bend the spoon with
I
your
need
mind.
Need total concentration,
okay.
Total quiet.
Okay, so we're going to have some quiet in the studio. Okay.
Okay?
Everyone's going to have to stop laughing at all the jokes we're making over here.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. I'm going to pass out. All right, okay, hold on.
Okay, we have to do this quickly.
All right, I'm going to do it. Fine. Come on! Okay, I'm using my mind, I'm using my hand. Hey, I bend it with my hand, right?
Oh,
using my mind, right?
That was great. That's Sean's show and tell. Wow.
Basically, I learned a lot of
and,
stuff.
And we'll be right back after a word from our sponsor. Wow, Sean's show and tell. Right back.
The Tom Green Show has been brought to you by Darkstorm Comics and Collectibles, 335 Lisgarud Bank. Darkstorm offers both mainstream and alternative comics, as well as Japanese animation. Darkstorm does not sell Glenn Humblick paraphernalia, but they do sell comics. Darkstorm Comics, proud sponsors of the Tom Green Show.
And now the Zoomalactics are going to do a song for us. So you have a, what's the name of the song, Gus?
Pro Kid.
Yep.
Okay, Zoomalactics here.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Word up. 95, getting live, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we're here on the Tom Green Show today.
Representing.
Something a little different, you know.
West Side.
You
all y'all.
West Side.
And all the peeps at home.
Yeah.
The more we relax and just listen.
Everywhere.
We're gonna kick it like this.
Yeah.
Die a pro kid, now check it.
So so, the higher living, living so so. Born a pro kid, die a pro kid, now check it. So so, the higher feeling, I'm feeling so so. Born a pro kid, die a pro kid, now check it. So so, the higher chilling. Born a pro kid, die a pro kid, now check it.
Sights I see, skin tone reflexes ebony
upon me.
I was created in the 70s. T.O. was the place of birth, things got expensive, so we had to jet to O-double-T-A-W-A. I'm four now, is the time I enter the Ramsey process. Ethnic cultures be dwelling in this area, racist rednecks just love the colors, nigga. Mom and dad never put up with that, I was taught, if you push me, I'll punch your back.
Cause it was way back, before peoples was trapped,
you best believe that.
Just a length we trapped and I can see that. Forms of shade is a fact.
Ain't nothing new, Jack.
It's on the same old crap.
So why they frontin', kid?
It's maybe where they live, but at my crib. I'm pouring liquor to forgive and remember that late night in October, y'all remember. The damn ish in the paper, why they baker? My homie come clean with the caper, they left him in a
state of
battling,
babbling, non-stop ruckus.
Pretend to be with influences, hopefully to send water to burning dumb minds and burning
whack MCs.
I'm burning with stress inside,
I'm burning Mr. Colise.
Can't complain how you feel, you feel intimidated.
Left
can't see the real of it all, like am I rejected? Holding your words, yes, I can't already
murdered your tongue.
Got that chance to pip your girl,
much too young.
So I skip my chance and I stay in school.
Hoping blood's in the water, almost drowned in a cesspool.
Tying my shoe to untie the face of a rat.
Can't explain your position, no matter cause beginning with that. So-so, so how you
feeling?
Living? So-so, born a broke kid, die a broke kid, now check it. So-so, so how you
feeling?
I'm feeling so-so,
born a broke kid, die a broke kid, now check it.
So-so, so how you chillin'?
I'm chillin' so-so,
born a broke kid, die a broke kid, now check it.
With the next sperm in line penetrated the egg before me, would it be me?
Plus LC,
I could be joined, discovering massive phenomenon. Now, these songs will make my name live on and on forever. Never clever MCs with the lever I pull to release the ever so cold.
That's the ice I hold.
Keys are centuries, puffin' G's. East to west, where I represent but never rest.
Boy, you can't test.
Quiz me, I don't think you can. Jeopardy, my intellect expands. I was Captain Nemo, damn. I'll be mashing up storms, it's like a typhoon. From the womb to the tomb, I will resume my style. Status with the fattest rhymes and curve lines. Make go shines, I'm the baddest, and you're just a crack addict. With all the static, my format's acrobatic. And if it was 7 Pacific, it'd be 11 Atlantic.
Like cable, I'm able to get ill.
Like Paul Teal,
steal the portal and wheel. Mortal Kombat, crack kill. Wait a second, recollecting the time forgotten. Pick a cotton on the plantation.
What is it?
Sensational.
We think we be one on shorter than a pair.
After 400 years of despair.
Where are we at? We be that shade that represents darkness. Mysterious blockness.
Towards the forefront, the fitness of the mind. Freaky, sneaky, loony styles are bright. My mental high, I visualize. Empty beaving, buried alive. Times are rough and times are hard. So let's we go. Run, give seeds, catch a fat lip if they talk. Born a pro kid, die a pro kid. Now check this kid. As I sizzle through your brain, just like acid.
Life after death, after death, after death, after death. After death.
That's how you do it.
Wow, that's scary. Holy cow, look, the camera's all close. It's never that close. The Zoomalactics, everyone. That was the Zoomalactics. Wow. That was exciting. So next week, among other guests, Jacqueline Holtzman will be on the show, so tune in. You know, let's all tune in. And there's going to be a palm reader as well, right?
Yeah.
Palm reader? Oh, okay. So then we'll be able to find out from her who's on the following week. Okay, so let's. I guess that's it for the show then, right? Is it over?
Yeah, looks like it.
It was fun. I had fun. Did you have fun tonight?
Yeah.
Okay, well, let's hear more. Let's hear more from the Zoomalactics then. You guys got... You have
a chat for y'all.
All right. I... Yeah, no, you can, yeah. You did, so...
Yo. Nah, rewind that beat.
Okay.
Yo, I'm going to free something else.
What do you want to do?
I don't know.
You come okay, over this. I'm gonna introduce myself. I'm Mysterio. This is my nigga Cash.
Yeah,
and my
yeah.
nigga Jerry, yo, otherwise known as Looney. This is my boy here.
Clauzel.
This is my boy Alias. Word. And this is my boy BOC, Dun. Otherwise known as Boz. We're gonna do a song called Run.
Right? We have it done.
This is how we run.
We have it done. Ha, ha, ha. Intellects combined in the nowhere state of mind.
True to find.
The interlock to the seven signs.
Destroyed by the mark of the beast. Your time is done. Chaos has you hung in the form of 1, 2, 6 Sumalactics.
Avenging with the tactics.
Strapped with matches.
Light in urban darkness.
Oozing all the cities of the world.
Tornadoes twirl.
Hurricanes come in vain. Make minds insane.
Pow. Minutes turn to hours. Who got the power? Nobody run things.
Yo, anarchy ruin things.
It's a war of the physics. Mentally you ain't uh-oh. And is he smart? You is dangerous.
To the maximum force of the final core.
We in the land beyond the laws. More execution than the Holocaust.
Ice agents campaigns. We so heated up. You drop bomb, but we exceed altitude
to the final Woo! Stage.
Yo, will your last breath is decay.
Oh my gosh, hey,
say it's done.
Ha, 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 it's half it done.
Ha, ha, ha,
it's half it done.
Ha, ha, ha,
it's half it done.
Yeah, yeah.
Ha, ha, ha.
Go to the finish.
Missing life force, of course, it's him.
M-I-S-T-E-R-I-O.
M-O-O, my man.
I'm back to the internal existence.
With the fitness of mental quickness.
Witness being naked as they subtract my life away.
Yo, it's fun. There's no more playing stupid.
You tell me I can D-I-E.
Not telling when, that's why my eyes be staying open 24-7.
The final frontier is soon be here.
Yeah, 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 encore.
I jam like Al Gore or Al B for sure.
Purify.
Shivers I stand for yeah. Eyeball scans the land. Earth, wind, and sand.
Fire, retire, in which the word has king.
Name it, so it remains a name. Direct the heck, you know, check who we be.
B-O-D.
Mr. Mystery, D. Oh, and the E.
Rock,
Glenn, Humphlick, Crazy Glenn, the Humphlick.
Crazy Glenn.